Hello students, in this video we are going to see about letter writing. Now, how many types of letters are there? There are two types of letters, informal letter and formal letter. Now, in exam, for this question, they will give you actually a notice, an advertisement, some information, and depending on that, actually that will be the topic. And depending on that, there will be a choice either to write a formal letter or an informal letter. So you have to read the given notice, given advertisement, information nicely, use the points given in that, and then you have to write the letter, solve the activity. Now, as I said, there are two types of letter, informal letter and formal letter. Now, what is informal letter? Informal letters are the one which you write to your friends and relatives. Which you write to your friends and relatives. Or the people you know well. Okay? These are informal letters. What is the other one is formal letter. Formal letter, you write to the people like teacher, principal, officers, editor of newspaper, manager, etc. People who are on a certain post. Now, if we compare both the letters, we find that informal letters are, how they are? The language is casual, you can say the language is informal, okay? These letters are a bit, the body of this letter is a bit lengthy. The language that you have to use should be figurative. Okay, informal language you have to use. The language should be figurative, means you should use phrases, proverbs and all you can use to make the letter appealing. And this letter should give a hint about closeness and about your relation with the person to whom you are writing the letter. This is not the case with formal letter. Why? The language is formal. The letters are brief and short and to the point. You don't write anything extra or something more than it is needed. Okay? Language should be simple. Language should be simple. Okay? So these are the things which you should remember while writing informal and formal letter. I hope you might have understood the meaning of informal and formal letter. Okay, informal, the one which you write to your relatives and friends or to the people who are you closely associated with. Formal letter, I have given the name, teacher, principal, officer, manager, editor, anyone. Official letters to whom you are writing. Language is simple. It should be to the point. It should be brief. It should be short and specific. This is not the case with informal letter. Informal letter should be beautifully written. Okay. Now these two have their certain format. These two have their certain format. Plus there are a bit some regular types which are asked in the exam. Okay. For example, there formal letters are many, and the one which usually are asked in exams are applications of different type. Applications like leave application. Yes, then which other application you write? Application for job application. Then you write application for admission. Application for admission. So, actually, in many books you will find that they have divided letters in three categories: informal to relative and friends, applications they mention it as formal letter, and some letters they put in the category of semi-formal letters. So which are these types which are put in semi-formal? So these are most often asked is complaint letter. Okay, complaint regarding some problem, frequent power cuts during exam, then garbage collected in the colony, then there is permission letter. Okay, permission letter, you want permission to visit Nangzaya sanctuary, that will be a permission letter. Then order letter, then inquiry letter, you want to take admission or you want to take you want to join something and you want to inquire about the details, inquiry letter, order letter, permission letter, even suggestion letter is there. So these are the formal letters which are usually asked in the exam. Okay, now, and what about informal letter? There are certain types which are usually asked. These letters, as I told you, you write to your relatives, mother, father, uncle, aunt, anyone, or your friends. Okay, and usually the topics are little bit similar, like you are suggesting something, you are giving an advice, you are applauding, appreciating, congratulating. So there are certain types. But if you ask me, remember one thing: informal letters are less scoring than formal letter. So while preparing for exams, it is always better to prepare formal letter and write formal letters in exam. Why? Because the body is short and simple. You don't have to give it a much thought. It means you have to be very precise, very clear. They are not lengthy and the format is such that you score more in formal letter. So let us see the format. We will see these letters in some other video where I will explain to you how you can write these letters and score good marks. So formal letter and informal letter. Now we will see the format of both the types of letter and why I am saying that in exam you should opt for formal letter. Okay, first we will see the format of informal letter. Now remember that the question is for 5 marks. You are expected to write in 100 to 120 words. Okay, and you have to write the letter in block form. Earlier we used to write letters in indented form. Indented, here you used to write your address, then sender's address, receiver's address, subject, again salutation, paragraphs were not to the margin, used to leave some space and start. No, this is indented form, indented style of writing letter, but now you have to write in block form. Block form, actually, since the time we have started sending mails and typing and sending printed letters, it has become a norm. It is less time consuming when you write block form because you start everything from the margin. All the things are left aligned. They are close to the margin. Okay. So you start with sender's address, means your address. Remember, the address should be like how it should be. You should write name, address, okay, place. So this is sender's address, how it should be, XYZ. You should write the names which has been given in the activity sheet. If it is not given, you can write any other name, okay, or you can write XYZ. Now your name, address, okay. Then here you have to mention the date. Here you have to mention the date, comma, comma. Then date, a place, okay, and how you are going to write the date. Always remember one thing, don't write date like this. In letters you should write it like 1st of January 2021, full stop. Is it clear? Okay, so here you are expected to write date, and date you should always write like this. Okay, so for this you have half marks for writing sender's address and date. Then comes salutation. Salutation. Now this being informal letter, it will be obviously dear. And you can mention dear mama, dear papa, dear. You can mention the name if you are writing to your brother or sister. Okay. Then here also you have to write comma. And then your letter start. As it is written in block form, everything should be near the margin. Aligned to the margin. This is the body of the letter. Always remember that body should be in 2 to 3 paragraphs. Body should be in 3 to 4 paragraphs. 3 minimum, and maximum you can have 4 to 5. Okay. Body should be in 3 to 4 paragraphs. In the first paragraph, actually you write the reason for writing the letter. But this being informal letter, you just can start with any phrase and how you were missing and you thought, or how you came to know about something and you thought of informing. Okay, reason in beautiful hand. Now, second paragraph, you have to give details. You have to give details, and these details from the points given in the question. Details from the points given in question. Okay, you should use points given in the question. Okay, you have to use all the points. The points which you can explain, write 2 to 3 sentences about it. If you can't, you should just make it short and simple. Then just in the third paragraph you have to take leave. It being informal, you can say that you will write and you are awaiting a reply. Okay, now then your complimentary clause means yours loving, no apostrophe here, yours loving and all, and here you have to write the name. Okay, now this carries half mark, this carries 2.5, this half, and complimentary clause half marks. Okay, and 1 mark is for grammatically correct structure of the sentences that you have used in the body of the letter. I hope the format is clear to you. It should be in block form, aligned to the left sender's address, at least in 3 lines, with name and the address and the place. Date, I told you how to write it. Dear, salutation, you can write the name or the relation you share with the person. Body should have 3 to 4 paragraphs. First paragraph is usually the reason of writing the letter. Second paragraph, detailed explanation should be there. Use the points given in the question. I told you how the questions have been formatted now. There will be an ad, a notice, a newspaper clipping about something, and accordingly the question will be set. So you have to likewise use those points. Take your leave, reply, you can reply awaiting your wait for your reply, eagerly waiting, looking forward to meet you in the valley vacations and all. Like this you can write at the end yours loving, complimentary clause, and your name. So this is how you have to write informal letter. Now the format of formal letter. How is the format of formal letter? we will see now. Format of formal letter. Now, what is the difference? Why I am saying that formal letters you should try? Because you can score good marks, because there are so many elements, the different aspects that you use in the format for writing these letters. Again, it starts with sender's address and date. I have already mentioned how you should write sender's address and how you should write date. Then, two. And after that will come receiver's address. Now, when you are writing receiver's address, the first will be to the, and here you have to write the designation. Designation means the post. To the teacher, to the principal, to the officer, to the manager, to the editor. Okay? Here you have to mention the address and here the place. Now again you are not expected to write the date. Okay? Then after that you have to write subject. Subject always should be, if it is coming in two lines, see that you write it, don't write it here. It should be clear on the paper. Subject is given in the question itself. Write a letter complaining about the garbage collected in the area. So, complain about the garbage collected. It should be short. It should be in 5 to 6 words. Not more than that. You can use the word regarding and you can continue. Okay. Then comes salutation. How is the salutation? It's always better to write respected. It can be sir or madam. Okay. So, this is the salutation. Now, in some letters, we also have reference. If it is job application, if it is in response to some advertisement, you write reference too. What is reference? It is written along with subject, and there you write from where you got the knowledge from, where, which aspect you are referring about. Your advertisement in this newspaper and all, you can write there along with the date. So, respected sir and madam. And again, now the body of the letter. Body of the letter should be in 3 to 4 paragraphs. Again, all the paragraphs will start from the left side of the margin. Okay, first paragraph, reason of writing the letter. You can introduce yourself also, because these are the people who don't know you, and you can mention I, with respect to this, I hereby wish to inform you, or I hereby wish to inform you about the sorry state of roads in our area, or about the frequent power cuts. So, the first where you are writing reason, it is already given in the question. It's related to the subject that you have written. Remember, here if I am writing regarding the garbage collected, I, the undersigned, hereby wish to inform you, hereby wish to complain about the garbage collected in our area. Understand? So, always remember, the first paragraph is related with the subject that you have written here. Okay, second paragraph, you should write it in detail and use the points given in the question. Use the points given in the advertisement or the news notice, etc. In the question. That is actually a part of question. So, question. Okay. Third paragraph. Request them for an early and immediate action. You can request them for an immediate action. Okay. So, this is how the body will be. Then, complimentary clause. How it will be? Now, it will not be yours loving or something. It will be yours faithfully or truly or something like this. okay, whatever you want to write, and XY is red, or the name you have written up if it is already given in the paper. So this is how you are expected. This is complementary clause. So how is the distribution here of marks? If you see the distribution of marks half here, this half, this is half subject and salutation, half mark, 1.5 year, 2.5 marks, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1 mark for grammar. In informal letter, actually, you have 2.5 mark for the body, and here you have 2 marks for the body. 1 mark for the grammatically correct structure that you have used in the letter. In informal, 2.5 mark for the body, and informal, 2 marks for the body. Now, this is how you are expected to write the format. This is the format actually of formal letter. Now, always remember, the first paragraph is usually same. Only the second paragraph differs according to the type of letter, formal letter, which has been asked. If it is complaint letter, if it is order letter, if it is order letter regarding books, you have to mention number of books, name of books, quantity you want, okay? Then if it is a suggestion letter, you can give numbers and put the suggestions. It looks more effective. Okay, so I hope you might have understood. In this video, we discussed about 2 types of letters, formal, informal. I told you that it's better to opt for formal letter in the exam because there are many elements, body is short and precise, and you can score out of marks or means you can score nicely in these letters. Study the format. See that you follow the format, letters are left aligned, so remember that and use the points given in the question, which can be in any form. Do subscribe to the channel to enrich your English. Thank you.